Okay, I would like to share with you all about the powering EV battery industry in Indonesia. Why I use a word powering, not electrifying, yeah? Because PLN not only providing electricity for the EV battery industry in Indonesia. So, what kind of rule of PLN for the EV battery industry in Indonesia? We have at least five rule of PLN. Number one, of course, as utility company, we will provide electricity supply for everything, yeah, if we can, yeah, in Indonesia. Sorry, yeah, some of my presentation still in Bahasa, but I will explain in English. And the second is PLN is not only provide electricity for the industry, but also, you know, we think about the how can we produce EV battery in Indonesia. So we have collaboration between state-owned company in Indonesia, MAN-ID, Antam, Pertamina, and PLN to establish a new holding company. We call it Indonesia Battery Corporation. And if we talk about the EV battery, of course, we talk about electric vehicle itself. So PLN as utility company also have mandatory for building EV infrastructure in Indonesia in form of EV charging station and also battery swap of EV. And after that, not only talking about the upstream, but also in case of PLN and utility company, we also talk about the downstream that we can utilize the battery not only for electric vehicle, but for the grid purposes. We call it energy storage system. And the last thing, we also would like to create new services to our customer. We call it a premium services to customer who needs some high power quality. So for that services, we can also utilize battery. This the electricity supply we can provide to such industry of EV battery. This is for example, yeah, one location in still ongoing to be built because we still on intensive discussion with the potential global partner. So if we talk about the mining, the expal, the precursor plant, cathode, battery plant, actually we need about 330 megawatt for the mining to battery plant. If we talk about the mining for the 10 million ton saprolite and 6 million ton limonite, this baseline for the production. So we need 330 megawatts. Based on the PLN supply demand right now, it's okay, no problem with the supply. Only 330 megawatt is you know just peanut yeah for PLN because PLN right now has over 14,000 megawatt reserve capacity around Indonesia today. So I would like to say don't worry about the electricity supply for the EV battery industry. You can see the figure that all of our system in the green condition. It means the electricity is secure and the reserve margin more than 30%. Only two region in West Kalimantan, in Bangka, we have reserve margin less than 30%. But it's okay, it can be mitigated yeah, by the overcapacity from other region. But based on this figure, we can say that don't worry about the electricity availability. And also, if we talk about the EV, electric vehicle battery, Actually, we talk about the EV ecosystem. Yeah. As I already mentioned, that we have several program. We build a consortium of EV battery industry. We have some collaboration with private to build EV charging station. We also have the open opportunity for everyone who want to join the market of EV charging and swap battery. We also provide the electricity indeed, yeah, for the need of the industry. We also launch the incentive for the electric vehicle owner, and also we already developed some application tool. We call it e-mobility cash-in. That's the first thing we the second thing we did is we build some consortium, yeah, between PLN, Pertamina, MNID, and Antam to build the industry end to end for the mining to the recycle. Of course, we right now already had some potential global partner already signed the MOU and now going to the head of agreement. That the impact of battery industry based on our study, yeah, actually this is the huge project and very strategic for not only for our consortium among the company but also for Indonesia. So this is the GDP impact if we can be a global producer for nickel sulfate, and this the impact if we can be global player for precursor and cathode, and this the impact, yeah, for the economy of Indonesia if we can be the global player for battery, EV battery, yeah, can be EV battery for electric vehicle or for the energy storage system. This is the number of job creation can be created by this industry, and this additional trade balance impact we will can achieve, yeah, if we can build the industry. This is the timeline of Indonesia EV battery industry. This company has been established by Minister of State on Company. We hope that the EV, the battery, can be operated starting to 2025. And this for number three, how PLN develop EV charging station. Right now, we have installed 32 EV charging station in 14 cities, and our target this year, 168 EV charging station, new EV charging station. Next is instead of PLN, of course, we open the opportunity for everyone who have interesting, yeah, to build together, to develop together the EV charging station in Indonesia. This is the EV charging station built by non-PLN. The latest one I heard that Shell has already built one EV charging station in Jakarta. This also we already developed this cash-in is the, you know, like application. This is the for connecting the driver with the charging station, with the home charging, so to be able to do charging with the effective way, with the safety, the secure way, because using this cash-in, we can do charging by many options of payment, yeah, and also this use this application app, we can monitor with the charging station location, with the close charging station, and what the status of charging station still on use or already off use. Yeah. And this is the roadmap of EV charging station we have. So right now we in this stage, yeah, we would like to achieve this number this year, and regularly we will increase the number based on the number of estimated EV charging station will be exist in the road in Indonesia. So this is the business model of EV charging station already regulated by Minister Energy number 13 2020. So if you have interesting to build to operate this EV charging station, you can buy the electricity provided by PLN. The price about 714 rupiah. You can purchase. You can sell the electricity to the end user maximum up to 2,466 kilowatt hour. This the regulation, the business model of EV charging station in Indonesia. And for the battery swap, actually we still ongoing to develop this business model, because we have still challenging issue with the standardization of battery. Because the key for the swap battery, the battery swap is the battery of motorcycle, electric motorcycle should be standardized first. And instead of electric vehicle itself, I already mentioned that PLN as utility company can utilize battery for other purposes, for our purposes to the electricity grid. We have at least 5 use cases. Number one, this case here, is we can deploy portable batteries to remote rural area to increase the ratio of electrification, such as in Maluku Utara region is very isolated, very remote, so it's not easy to build the infrastructure of electricity. So we can provide this portable battery for the solution. Number two is about how we deal with the so exponential of penetration renewable energy, especially variable renewable energy like wind turbine and PV solar. So we should deal with the intermittency so we can use also the battery storage, the battery technology. And number three, about renewable solar PV battery co-location in remote areas. So this use case, actually we build to change the diesel station that still use fuel oil with solar PV and battery. So we can reduce fuel oil consumption, we can increase the renewable energy penetration. And at the same time, we hope that the electricity cost production will be decreased. And then number four, for the large system, such as in Jawa Bali and Sumatra, Sulawesi, we can also utilize battery for reduce the peak power provision for peak saving. So we can charge the battery during the day, during the base load, with the cheap price of electricity, and at the peak hours between 6 to 10 p.m., this is the peak hours of electricity, with the electricity cost is very expensive, we do discharge of battery. So the cost of charge discharge of the battery is competitive comparing to other power plant, thermal power plant based on the fossil fuel. And the last thing is about, I already mentioned that actually we have some new services for the such customer who need some high power quality, that they don't want to have some interruption of electricity supply like that. So we estimate that in the next 5 years we can have demand of more than 3 gigawatt hour of battery energy storage. This is the last one I already mentioned earlier, that we would like to create some PLN premium services. So we do partnering with battery manufacturer to offer complete solution to commercial and industrial customer. Because some customer need the really high of quality of the power supply. So it means not only have some interruption, but sometimes they need no flicker at all during 24 hours of operation. So we estimate there is huge potential market for these services. We estimate at least $400 million we can give if we can create these premium services to our customer in the next 5 years. So I think that's all of my presentation. Thank you for your time, for your attention.